In part two of our lesson on half-angle identities, you will learn how to simplify expressions using the half-angle identities. In this first example, we have to find the exact value of the sine of 15 degrees using a half-angle identity. Now we know that the identity for sine of a over 2 is that it is plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine a divided by 2. We want to find the sine of 15 degrees, so we can write that as the sine of 30 degrees over 2, because 30 divided by 2 is 15. Now that it's in this form, we can apply this identity and say that this will be plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of 30 degrees divided by 2. Now, right away, we can actually choose the plus or minus sign because we know that 15 degrees is in quadrant 1. So that's going to make us choose the positive because sine is positive in quadrant 1. So this will equal the square root of 1 minus, we know that the cosine of 30 degrees is radical 3 over 2, and that whole numerator is over 2. This is all under the radical. We now have a complex fraction. We will want to clear that out. Because this extra denominator in there is a 2, we'll multiply by 1 in the form of 2 over 2. So it's not because this denominator is a 2, it's because this little denominator here is a 2, so we're going to clear that out. So this will be the square root of, we have to distribute the 2 in the numerator. So 2 times 1 is equal to 2 minus 2 times radical 3 over 2 will be radical 3. In the denominator, we have 2 times 2, which is 4. We can simplify square root of 4, so that denominator will become 2. And in the numerator, we have radical 2 minus radical 3. And this is the simplest form of the answer for sine of 15 degrees. Notice that it's okay to have a radical underneath another radical. We just can't have a radical in the denominator. And that was made pretty easy for us. In this one, we had radical 4 in the denominator, which became 2. In this next example, we have to simplify each expression. Now, we've done this before, and my suggestion is you look at your list of identities, and underneath the given expression, you write the piece of the identity that most looks like the expression that you have. So in this case, this looks the most like plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of a over 2. Now we know that this is equal to the sine of a over 2. So then that means we can go back to our expression and say that this is going to have to equal sine of 25 degrees over 2, which simplifies to be sine of 12.5 degrees. when we check out this next expression and we compare it to our list of identities, we can see that it looks the most like sine of A divided by 1 plus cosine of A. And we know that that is equal to the tangent of A over 2. That lets us come back up to our expression and write that it's going to have to equal the tangent of its argument over 2. Now, its argument is theta over 8, and we have to divide that by 2. Now, remember that dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1/2. So this would turn into tangent of theta over 8 times 1/2, which is the tangent of theta over 16. Let's go ahead and check your understanding on this one. So pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. For this one, we start with the given expression, then, looking at our list of identities, we see that this expression looks the most like plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine of A over 2. And we know that that has to equal the cosine of A over 2. We come back up to the expression and say that this is going to equal the cosine of its argument, which is 3 theta over 2, over 2. Whatever the argument of the cosine function on the inside becomes the argument that you put over 2. As we just saw in the previous example, this will turn into cosine of 3 theta over 2 times 1/2, because dividing by 2 is multiplying by 1/2. So this becomes cosine of 3 theta over 4. This last example, the piece of the identity that this looks the most like is plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine A over 1 plus cosine A. And we know that that has to equal the tangent of A over 2. So this expression is going to have to equal the tangent of its argument, 6x, over 2, which becomes the tangent of 3x. So once again, you will really make life easier for yourself if you take just a few seconds to write the piece of the identity underneath the given expression. We did that here, we did that here. You write the other half of the identity, and then above it, apply that to the given expression. I think you'll find you can be really successful on these problems.